So here is the code. All right. So first thing that we need to understand is any page that we are creating, custom page, the program or the code of that page will start with this tag, apex page tag, and that will end with this tag. So this, these are tags, okay. The code will start with this and will end with this tag. That is one. Okay. Now, this is a mandatory thing. Any page needs to have these opening and ending tags. Okay. Between these tags, you can put whatever content you want. Okay, let's say congratulations has come. How about you? Okay, I have put how are you in a separate line, but it still appears in the same line here. Okay, the reason is line break you will have to do using again the code. So there is a simple tag for breaking the line, which is this br slash, save it. Now you'll see the line break here. Okay, now congratulations, if you want this part to be bold, there's another thing that we can do with it. We can put it in a B tag. B is a bold tag. So it's a tag which will make the text bold. So if you cover any text with this tag, it will make it bold. Line break we have given. How are you if I want to make it italic? There is another tag similar which is called italic I tag. Right. So we have our fix the page for the page. We have this apex tag, apex page tag, starting and ending of the page should be there. Whatever you want in the page, you should be putting it here. Okay. So now we have just created a very simple page, simple one which we are using for just writing this much. Now there's more content which we can put into this, right? So we'll just get into that part. So far I think things are clear with you all. Okay, if you are wondering that what is this B tag and what is this I tag, simply, you know, these are tags for making the text bold, italic, things like that. Okay, people who have never worked on HTML, for them this thing might be a little new. People who have worked on HTML, they might be aware of this thing, right? So my question to all of you who do not know HTML, people who do not know HTML, do you understand the logic of this B and I? Is it simple to understand or it is very difficult to understand? I just want people who do not have HTML background or who have not worked on HTML any time to reply back to this. Did you understand this B and I logic? Bold and italic thing?
Mm-hmm. this language which we are using, this is Visual Force, right?
Mm-hmm.
So why we are using this FX tag?
No, that is the syntax. So that is what they call, you know, put it here.
Okay. So in Visual Force, we have to use this FX tag.
Yeah, I mean, that is how they have named their tags. Instead of calling those Visual Force, they call it FX. Okay. So my question is, anyone who could not understand this logic, I for italic, B for bold, anyone who could not understand it, people who do not know HTML. And it would be good if we reply a little prompt on this. I do not want you guys to miss on anything. That is the reason why I would keep on asking these questions. And I would need a little cooperation from your side. Sriram, what about you? I would not be able to, you know, point out names and ask every time, so that becomes a little difficult. At the same time, I do not want to overlook any one of you. So please be a little more active in these sessions because this is a very important part of the training that we are going through. Okay, so I think we all understand these basics. So for people who are new to HTML or just know a little basics of HTML, I am going to share a small tutorial kind of thing with you all, which is W3 Schools. I think most of you might have heard of it. W3 Learn HTML. Okay. So in this W3Schools.com, we have very nice tutorials, simple tutorials, which will make us understand about the few basic tags of HTML. Why I want you to actually go through these basic tags of HTML? Because most of these HTML tags can be used in Visual Force. See, any Visual Force tag, let us understand this, any Visual Force tag will start with apex colon. So this is a Visual Force tag. And these are HTML tags. So what we can see here is, we are able to use HTML tags on our Visual Force page, right? So a lot of HTML tags can be used on Visual Force page. So for that reason, it will be good if we spend a couple of hours. You don't need to spend more than 2 hours. If you spend 2 hours on this line by line, introduction, basic, elements, attributes, headings, paragraph formatting. So just spend 2 hours. Don't go into little complex things like this. If you can come to list blocks, that is fine. And it will take one and a half hours. You will be very comfortable, you know, with all these tags very soon. Okay. So that is one thing. One thing that we do. Now the next thing that we'll have to get into is get into the Visual Force tags. Okay. So the designing of the page, whatever you do, we have HTML tags to do that, but HTML can only, you know, help us into this formatting of the text and all that stuff. Visual Force tags will help us connect our page with the database. Okay. See. Salesforce has a MVC structure. Okay, what is an MVC structure? It is a model view controller structure. What is this model view controller? Model is the data model, right? So Salesforce has three things actually. One is the front screen that you see. One